Good morning, I'm Trish Mahanik, and this is Cynopsis, your first early morning briefing. Heading into the weekend, today is Friday, February 20th, 2009. Here are today's top stories. Turner Sports and NBA Digital confirmed its NBA All-Star 2009 coverage last weekend hit a sweet spot with viewers as more than 44.1 million people watched on TNT, up plus 15% over 2008. Another 7 million viewed the coverage online and via mobile from February 13th through the 16th. Well, Wednesday's original series opener of Little Miss Perfect on WE TV at 10 p.m. attracted 224,000 women 18 to 49 viewers, as well as 209,000 women 25 to 54 viewers. MTV Tray unveils a new weekly bilingual and bicultural variety show next week, showcasing host and comedic talent Carlos Santos. Entertainment as a Second Language with Carlos Santos opens February 26th at 9 p.m. Weather in all its challenging forms will once again be chronicled in a new season of Storm Stories beginning this Sunday at 8 p.m. on the Weather Channel. The first five episodes coincide with the network's Tornado Week, airing February 22nd through March 1st. CBS and CBS Paramount Network Television are once again working with Canada's CTV on a new police drama called The Bridge, with production beginning later this spring in Toronto. CBS approved 13 episodes of the series, which will air next season in the U.S. on CBS and on Canada's CTV. The Bridge is a procedural police drama focusing on Toronto Police Union leader Craig Bromell. Bravo tapped Isaac Mizrahi and Kelly Rowland to host its new reality competition series, The Fashion Show. Both will head a panel of judges who will review the work of professional fashion designers. Already on board as a judge is Fern Mallis, who helped create New York's Fashion Week. 25/7 Productions made a deal with music act Nelly to host Nelly's Night in Vegas, a weekly primetime television show based in Las Vegas and showcasing major Hollywood stars. The series, produced by 25/7 Productions and Mad Cow, is executive produced by 25/7's Dave Broom, Madeleine Smithberg, and Nelly.
Hi, I'm John Cox, and this week I'd like to talk to you about formulaic TV shows. I pride myself in avoiding these shows, but there are three that I watch every week because I just like them too much. The first one is Law & Order. If you get arrested within the first 20 minutes, you're innocent. After that, get yourself an attorney. You're going to court, Jack. The second one is Worst Week. We all know what's going to happen to Sam 1 minute before it happens, yet the cast is so good and engaging, I watch it anyway. The last one is the most egregious of this group. It's the most formulaic show on TV, and yet it's one of my favorite shows. Let's say it all together. You know what I'm talking about. One, two, three. House. In the first 3 minutes of the show, someone is doing something ordinary, and then all of a sudden falls down and blood is coming out of some orifice. Then for the next 45 minutes of the show, everyone will be wrong about every diagnosis, about every test that they do. House will insult everybody that he meets, and will talk about hookers and boobs. And then comes the best moment of the show. At minute 53 or so, House is having a conversation unrelated to the case, and all of a sudden, he looks off in the distance and he gets a little smile on his face. That's when he discovered what's wrong with the patient, and he abruptly walks out of the room. And then at the end of the show, House has his incredible Hulk moment. That's when all of House's friends and colleagues are off doing whatever they're doing with their significant others, and House, much like Bill Bixby, at the end of every Incredible Hulk episode, is left alone with some music playing in the background. I'm John Cox, and that's just my opinion. Thanks for listening.
Thank you.
And on that note, that's a wrap for today and for the work week. Be sure to check your email for the full printed version of today's synopsis with new executive moves and more on ratings, some new classified ads, and a few other bits and pieces that did not make it into this podcast. And check out tonight's primetime broadcast lineup. This is a Cynopsis Media production in association with 311 West. For Cynthia Turner, who wrote and compiled Cynopsis, in Connecticut, I'm Trish Pahonik.
I'm gonna have a good day. If I make it myself, I'm gonna have a good day. I don't need no one else. I'm gonna have a good day. Nothing wrong I could do. I'm gonna have a good day. Hope you have a good day too.